I heard in my spirit these words to a song. I think it's from the 60s, maybe the 70s. Searching, searching, searching. I don't know what song it's from. I tried to find it. It doesn't matter. And then I heard, look up the words North Korea. And I began to search, knowing something was up about North Korea. Because North Korea has been launching missile tests since 1993. As you see here in this clip. And then I found a clip of an interview with Dick Cheney warning us of an impending EMP strike from North Korea. I'm going to play it for you.
The other thing I worry about, frankly, is this whole problem of the electromagnetic pulse and the threat that that represents to our electrical grid.
Explain that.
Well, if you set off a nuclear weapon a couple hundred miles above the United States, in terms of altitude, and it is designed so that it emits a lot of gamma rays. Those gamma rays, in effect, will strike our electrical grid and burn out a lot of major transformers that are part of that grid. And you end up in a situation where we're not talking just about a few days of loss of power or weeks. We're talking months or maybe even years. Those big transformers that are connected to the electrical grid aren't even built in the United States. They're built overseas. And when you take out the power grid, you take out most of our economy, our lifestyle, our ability to pump water, to pump gasoline, to feed, to grow the crops. I mean, it would literally shut down our civilization. And another source of that kind of problem would be a solar flare that came out far enough from the sun and struck the Earth, had to have to be at the exact right spot, and obviously in our orbit. That happened once before in 1849, I think. But the problem we're faced with is that our system is vulnerable, especially the civilian infrastructure from the standpoint of that. Everybody thinks North Korea to be a threat to the United States needs lots of missiles able to fly thousands of miles very accurately with warheads the way we do. They don't have to do that at all. All they've got to do is figure out a way to detonate one weapon a couple hundred miles over the Earth. And then, you get speculation about launching something like that from a freighter off our coast. And difficulty we would have dealing with that if they should ever be capable of doing that.
Now, this I've seen in visions and others here on YouTube, friends and just acquaintances here, and I've posted the videos about North Korea not being just a bag of hot air like most people think they are, making a joke of them, but they are being used to play with everyone's mind, and I want you to understand that. So let us look at their arsenal that I have a link to here. Four, I have sent out warnings, like I said here before, on North Korea. And many laugh, but soon you will laugh no more. Because they will hit North Korea and possibly other parts of the United States. For they will hit California and possibly other parts of the United States. For they are backed by China, as Iran is by Russia. And as I looked on the net, I was hearing North Korea is about to rise up and show the world who they really are. Now, this new leader is being made fun of like never before. He's trying to prove himself, and he will. And then I found this document that I've been reading, and it was packed full of information of many things that just blew me away, including things on the Pope and things that are happening right now in our history. Then I'm going to talk to you later about that, but I want to talk just about North Korea right now. And this document was telling us that the Illuminati has plans for North Korea to gain enough nuclear weapons to carry out all of its threats that they've been threatening us with. But not only that, we were warned about them before he ever started threatening by Yahweh. He's the one we need to be listening to anyway. He's God. as I found that they've recently restarted their nuclear plant. As I was searching and searching, searching, searching. As you see here in these pictures, Japan prepared itself this past April for a missile strike from Korea, as they warned to fire upon them, because they know it's going to come to pass, because their leader is Illuminati. But he's preparing his people. He wants to protect them. Unlike our leader here in America, he's not preparing us for what's going to happen to us. I want you to read this article, and then I'm going to be right back. And then we see here that North Korea was threatening, and has been threatening, South Korea, and said it should disappear, and that they're vowing to punish the South, and they have no rights to exist, or for public freedoms. And then the leader called Obama a monkey, which provoked Obama to think that he needs to make newer sanctions upon North Korea, which we all know that that doesn't do anything but punish the people. The leaders still get fat and still get all the food they need. So that won't do anything to that country. And they too have been threatening to turn Seoul into ashes. And as we know, the Lord has told us that these two countries will soon become one and will carry out these threats. Not as two, but as one. Because they've been meeting behind closed doors. Now, I had a really good link on that, but it disappeared off my desktop. And the South played a mind game on the North. I thought that was hilarious. With these balloons and USB drives. And one of the balloons read, "This regime must fall," but we know that's not going to happen. This type of propaganda is usually played by the North on the South most of the time. So that's why it cracked me up. It was kind of like they turned the table on them. And then on April the 1st, there was a fear that the North was conducting new testing in their underground nuclear test. And they were. There was an earthquake that was felt 80 miles from the peninsula. And I'm telling you, you can joke all you want about them, but they're not playing, because their missile range is no joke, my friend. And then one day, they will play no more. Just as warned here in this interview with Chaney, but I'm telling you, it will be more than an EMP. This I've seen. Because they're being backed by China, and their army is large, and they will follow the leaders doing whatever they say. Now, in all my searching, I was hearing in my spirit to wait for the very thing the Holy Spirit was showing me and telling me to wait for before I made this video. And then a very good friend of mine sent me this confirmation. And this is what I needed to conclude this video with. And before I play it, I need to ask you a question. Do you know who Jesus Christ is? Are you born again? If not, I need for you to ask Yahweh God to forgive you of all your sins today. In Jesus' name. And He will do so. And don't wait for tomorrow, because tomorrow could be too late. This is Ruby.